Applying to business school is expensive. Apart from the one-time expenses, such as GMAT, traveling to interviews and assessment days, and potentially hiring MBA admissions consultants to help them get into your favorite business school, you will be asked to pay application fees for each and every school you apply to. A lot of applicants hedge their risk and apply to multiple MBA programs, which I think is a wise decision. What's not so wise is paying the amount of fees requested. In this video, I will explain you guys how to avoid paying these unnecessary fees and save yourself hundreds, if not thousands of dollars. By the way, if you were wondering why business schools charge an application fee, the answer is very simple. Admissions committees have a tough job reading through lots of applications. They need to evaluate these applications, which can be quite tedious. And the application fee is basically for processing these applications. The application fee also serves sort of as a filter so that candidates who are not the right fit for the program think twice before they decide to start an application. Schools charge between $75 to $250 for the opportunity to apply. The average candidate applies to 5 schools or more and ends up paying more than $1,000 on application fees alone. But you don't have to do that. Once again, save yourself some money. Here are 13 ways to avoid the application fee that comes with every business school application. At some point, business schools have started to realize that application fees deter those candidates they want to apply, namely veterans, female candidates, candidates identifying as LGBTQ, every non-white race, and applicants who work for the government or in the nonprofit sector. But let's start step by step. Perhaps the easiest way to receive an application fee waiver is to register and attend one of the school's online admissions webinars, info sessions, or Q&A sessions. These webinars are great ways to learn about the schools directly from AdComs, current students, and alumni. Many schools offer you an application fee waiver just for signing on, and I strongly recommend you do this for every school you would like to go to. Not only for the free application, but also for the information you will receive in these webinars. They're normally very informative and helpful. Schools that offer this application fee waiver are Duke, UVA Darden, George Washington University School of Business, etc. Many schools want you to visit campus and will reward you with an application fee waiver for doing so. Some schools allow anyone who attends a class visit or a guided campus tour to be granted a waiver. Others require you to attend special events like on-campus diversity weekends. For example, Cornell's Johnson School of Business grants application fee waivers to all who attend their Johnson Women in Business and Johnson Means Business diversity events. Schools that offer this application fee waiver are Cornell Johnson, MIT, Washington Foster, and so on. If you get lucky, you may walk away from an MBA fair with some application fee waivers to your target schools. This is rarely advertised and you really have to get lucky. Make sure to talk to the representatives of the schools and express your interest in the program you would like to apply to, and they will be generous to offer you a discount code or a full application fee waiver. Schools that offer this application fee waiver are USC Marshall, Indiana Kelly, Georgia Tech, and many more. The Forté Foundation's MBA Launch Program is designed for women interested in applying to an MBA program. You apply to the program in the fall prior to applying to the business school. For example, if you wanted to apply to business school next year, you would apply in October. The program costs $550 plus $25 application fee. It includes 10 months of GMAT prep webinars, admissions webinars, a dedicated support group, a peer advisor, free calls with admissions consultants, and application fee waivers. It also may or may not increase your chances to securing Forté Fellowship funding during your MBA. There are a lot of schools that offer application fee waivers in this regard. For example, HEC Paris, IESE, INSEAD, MIT Sloan, and many, many more. I will put a link in the description below for more information. This is geared towards African Americans, Hispanic Americans, and Native Americans. However, these programs do accept other races that are committed in some way to increasing the representation of these groups. There are 20 member schools, and a single application with the consortium allows you to apply to up to 6 consortium schools. Application fees are tiered based on how many member schools you apply for, and range from $150 for 1 or 2 schools to $300 for up to 6 schools. This can save an applicant more than $1,000. Candidates are also eligible for full tuition scholarships. I will put a link in the description below if you want to know more about the consortium member schools. The only way to waive the application fee at Harvard Business School is to be an active duty military applicant. And this is a designation that will get you a waived fee at many business schools in the US. At some schools like Georgetown, you don't even have to be on active duty. Schools that offer this application fee waiver are Stanford, Yale, Berkeley, UCLA Anderson, and so on. Generally, business schools want people that desire to get involved and make an impact in their communities and the world. Therefore, it is no surprise that many schools reward former and current Peace Corps, AmeriCorps, and Teach for America active participants and alumni with application fee waivers. However, make sure to check the requirements of each school carefully. Some schools will state that you must apply within a few years of your service to be eligible for a fee waiver. Yale and some other US schools also accept Teach for China or Teach for India as eligible for a waiver. Schools that offer this application fee waiver are Duke, Chicago Booth, Berkeley, Cornell Johnson, Yale, etc. A few schools invite you to contact admissions if you have experienced severe financial hardship, and if you make your case, the fee may be waived. A school that offers this application fee waiver is, for example, Berkeley. Most schools list if they can accommodate requests for fee waivers on the requirements page of their website. If you are lucky enough to score a very high GMAT score, and you opted in to have GMAT share your score with partner institutions, you may just get some application fee waivers straight in your email. And there is nothing you have to do on your end, because those are available by invitation only. Schools that have offered this application fee waiver in the past are Texas McCombs, Rochester Simon, UNC Cannon Flagler, Rice Jones, etc. Similar to attending webinars, having a video call with a member of the admissions committee gives you the chance to ask important questions, and if you can make an interesting case for your application, they will automatically offer you a fee waiver at the end of the conversation. Some schools offer you application fee waivers if you obtain a recommendation letter from a current student or from alumni. Your contact person normally has to write a letter for you and state some facts in terms of when they graduated from the school, what kind of program they attended, and most importantly, how well they know the applicant. If you're a child of an alum and your parents or grandparents graduated from the business school to which you're applying to, then this is another way to save the application fee. Duke, for instance, has this option in place. Okay, this one is super basic. The most straightforward way to get an application fee waiver is if you simply ask for one. It doesn't always work, but in some incidences it does. So why not giving it a try? As you can see, every single top MBA program offers some form of application fee waivers, whether it's just a discount or a full fee waiver. However, they do not advertise this fact, and only less than 10% of applicants actually take advantage of these savings. So make sure to watch out for these and save yourself some money. A little disclaimer, all the schools I exemplary mentioned are subject to changes. Every other year, the schools change everything around application fee waivers. So if they offered these waivers in 1 year, they might not offer them the next year. Just keep an eye out for these money savers. So this is the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. Go ahead and smash that like button if you found this video valuable. I encourage you to subscribe to my channel to be updated on new videos. My name is Adrian. Stay safe and see you next time.